I'm thinking about spending my life with you. Swag while I be piping you. Montana of 300. Do not think you've ever heard of this guy.
Uh-uh.
This guy is on the come up. I'm surprised he's not more famous than he is already. Good. What?
Mine.
Why are you touching my face? I'm gonna be hopeful that you're gonna like Montana of 300.
Mm-hmm.
But I doubt that you are. Straight confidence.
That starts it off positively.
We're being positive, and I'm being positive in this way because he sings a lot about, he's from Chicago. He sings a lot about his life. He sings a lot about killing people.
Oh,
he sings a lot about his dick.
Oh no.
It's how it goes. Penis?
Mm-hmm.
I think dick is better than penis.
No.
No, because when I say penis, it sounds weird. Like dick just sounds like it's
how about
less
boy parts?
Member.
Member?
How about shaft?
Oh!
I've been on Montana for, I think since like 2015 is when I first heard one of his remixes. So he's actually a really smart businessman in the sense that when he got into rapping, he realized that in order to gain a following, he'd remix popular songs at the time and he would put his own verses over them. And he's a super, super, super talented lyricist. So like when you listen to these songs, I want you to really focus on what you're hearing.
Are you sure?
No, but like I know I said what he raps about, but what he actually raps about, he's really talented with his metaphors, with his use of words. Like he actually, and I swear on everything, okay. This is not me joking
whatever
around.
Whatever you say, like, I, oh, this is not me. Yeah, I see. Are they gonna go do a robbery? They're scary. The mouse scary. Those guys are freaky. Is that like supposed to be like enticing them?
No, well, he's comparing an ice cream truck to his van.
That full of stuff.
Full of killers. So it pulls up and ba-ba. You get the idea.
Yeah, I know what you mean by the rhyming stuff.
What?
Like he says nerf, turf. Like he's rhyming stuff.
every rapper rhymes stuff.
Told me to really listen.
I'm glad you're listening, but I'm just talking about his metaphors, like what he says, his relation to pop culture, the way he says his words, like he's just so good.
Ice cream truck where you pull up and then you just have your loaded. You're fully loaded. Like an ice cream truck.
Yes.
Except people don't come to you. You go out and kill them.
He's basically saying like he's in the ice cream truck. It's like he pulls up like the ice cream truck to your block and then it's just open fire.
Oh, wow. That sucks.
But that's something that he deals with in Chicago.
Know.
That's something that actually happens.
That is so sad. That is so sad that they're rushed out.
I love that you get so sentimental and so like emotional
but
about these
is.
Other people.
But it is. It's so sad that they have to pull up in a place like an ice cream truck. Why not have a real ice cream truck? Spread some love.
Do a drive-by in an ice cream truck?
No. Go to the neighborhood with treats.
I'm going to show you a remix now.
Mm-hmm.
So this is my favorite remix. Now he has a bunch of very, very popular remixes. All do well over like 23 million views. This one has 17 million.
Wow.
Others have 18 million. They do extremely well. Like he found his niche on remixing and making videos to him. And it's they're very
and
good.
And people just love it.
Because essentially when he makes these remixes, they're better than the original song in my
wow.
opinion.
Wow.
Which I think speaks a lot to how he raps.
Mm-hmm.
But the reason I like this one so much is this was kind of like the first big remix I heard about from him in 2015, and it just is so good, and it's literally just minutes and minutes of fire. Like, there's not a dull moment in the song, and it's featuring a guy named
Fire, Sam. Like real fire, or like action?
Social media accounts, nigga. Behind computers, all you do is run your mouth, nigga. Go make me pull up with some shooters at your house, nigga. Like what's all that shit you talking about, nigga?
Have you heard the other one? The other guy? And he's better?
I like this song. I like this version a lot better than the original.
Who's Montana? That one.
Mm-hmm.
Who's this guy?
That's Savage.
Oh.
Remember I told you Savage sings first, and then Montana comes in.
Yeah.
The remixing idea, because it's a way of getting a beat that you know is fire or that you know is good, and it, and you're putting your own spin on it. So you know it's, if it's like he, I think he's genius for. I mean, artists have been like remixing ideas forever, but the fact that he puts these big remixes behind him and.
So this is the other person's music.
Other right? person's beat, but he just puts his remix on it.
And he does his own words.
Yeah. I want to mosh. Like,
what does that mean?
Like, I want to get out and
start
punching people when I hear this.
Really?
Like, just start pushing people and punching people, and it makes me want to go, like, steal stuff.
Really?
Like, I want to go, like...
That's horrible. Then don't listen to it.
I want to just, like, pop, 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 pop. You know what I mean?
Honey, people are watching you. Don't say that stuff.
But when I hear it, I want to just, like...
People are listening to you. That's so ridiculous. Do not listen to him. He does not mean that. I'm serious.
Like, this song doesn't make me want to go steal, like, rob something or, like, rob someone or, like...
No.
This song
not
makes
really.
Me just want to get up and, like, do something crazy.
No. It makes me a little bit, like, it's not the most relaxing song.
Yeah, it's that's why I said it's just flame. Consistent flame. Consistent fire.
Like, it was nice. That, like you said, it kind of made me have a little anxiety. That kind of beat. You know what I mean?
Because it's just so, like, in your face. It's an in-your-face type
it's
video.
Okay, you know what it is? It's an aggressive song.
You don't want to just, bah, 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 and then get out of the car. Like, we'll take the minivan. You and me will roll up on someone without them knowing. That song is just, when I hear these songs, it just gets me, like, super turned. Like, I just want to go do something.
Okay.
But,
that
like
was
I said,
definitely not my type of working out video, like, song. That'd be a little bit, like, that'd be like a cycling class song.
You sound so white. We're gonna 180 completely, okay? Mm-hmm. I'm gonna show you a song. This song, this is where I mean he talks about his dick a lot, so he's gonna talk about his dick a lot in this song.
Oh, no.
But it's a good song. It's one of the songs.
Guys, this is out here.
It's one of the songs that's really blowing up right now. Mm-hmm. And it's really putting him in the spotlight for more mainstream music.
Count how many times they say penis.
There's a lot. It's like 3 minutes of penis.
I'm gonna start
It's a shaft
counting.
After shaft.
Oh, that's gross. Only thing on my mind is you. And whenever I'm hitting it, I'm thinking about spending my life with you. Okay, that's not bad there. See, she make me think I could sing, make me forget that I rap. She cooked me breakfast on the stove, I slide my dick in from the back. I'm in love one. With this bitch.
Are you counting?
Sure.
You thought you were
I am. I'm thinking about spending my life with you. See, he's almost like, it's nice, because it's like at first, he's like, oh, I want to be, have you be my wife? And then it goes
into just straight dick.
It's like, why ruin it? It's nice. It's like goes from this really cool, like, love into...
Yeah. Well, you remember, he's from Chicago. He's got to keep in that, he's got to keep that hood in there.
That made me feel nauseous. I can't.
If you've never listened to music with your mom, there are just certain songs that just make you feel just a tad bit uncomfortable, and this is probably one of them. It's just, I have to. You didn't like that one? You didn't like that?
Oh, I was all for that one.
How many times did he say dick? Or shaft? Or member?
Probably 30. I got, like, nauseous. You know, not that it's a normal thing, all that stuff, but it's like just to talk about it with everybody. I know, I'm so much more private. That is so oh! Are you fucking filming this?
Yeah.
Now, who is this person? Those people.
Who are his friends?
Yeah.
I couldn't tell you. From heaven, they want my spot, they want me dead and want a murder confession. I'm cursed with a blessing, my work is impressive on this beat.
Okay, these masks are like freaking scary. They need to take their masks off.
But the fact
they're scary,
that's the idea. I'm sure a lot of them have like sentences they don't want to be known for in the video.
I know, but that is scary. They scare that mask scare me. Like, if somebody were to come up like that. or if I were to see that on the street, I'd be like,
is what my level is. Wings up in the sky, man. This guy is flyer than Pegasus. I'm all about my cheddar. It's MOB, never sweat a bit. I know you sick, but I'm gonna ball just like a cancer patient. Couldn't hold me down, don't give a fuck if you was gravitation.
I think out of all the songs we've listened to tonight, I think this one really does a lot of justice on his flow, like his lyricism. Like, I think it really shows his talent.
His songs are like, what's the word, like really powerfully aggressive, like,
yeah,
like there's real meaning and feeling in all of them.
Yes, well, he sings about what's really happening in his life. Most rappers do, but he does a good job of portraying it.
But you can feel like his, like,
that's the power, know, like, of his lyricism, like, he does a good way of explaining it, and I'm glad you understood that, because that's what I've been trying to tell you.
Wow, I would not listen to this before bedtime at all.
Doesn't it make you want to go rob someone?
Oh, I like feel here like the like nervous.
Makes me want to just like start moshing.
No, I feel like I'm like wow, like I need to go like now to therapy and like get rid of my anxiety. Whoa, okay, now I gotta go run on my treadmill, get rid of my aggression.
Doesn't it? It does. It makes you. He does a. Like I said, and I'll say it again real quick.
I'm so sorry. You still have cat hair. There's hair in you. I'm sorry. I'm seeing in this. You weren't kidding.
No, I literally said songs are about guns, violence, and dicks. And lots of fire.
Stop saying that.
Hey, well, we're going to end the video here. And we've been going a lot longer than usual. I'm feeling good tonight. I drank a coffee like 10 minutes ago. And I just hit the gym, so I'm feeling real good. If you want to cop a shirt, first link in the description. You can get hats, you can get shirts. We just dropped a bunch of stuff. It supports my podcast. It supports my buying habits. Check it out. You don't need to buy anything.
And I don't want to pay for anything anymore for him. Buy it.
Shit, block spit, hit his noodles, get the chopsticks. And money cheese, bought a brand new 45. Free money. He already ran through like 45. Ma, get on run.